Everybody, and welcome to this video, and I want to say Happy New Year. That's a weird W, but that's okay. Happy New Year to you guys. 2018 is a brand new year. It's a chance for you to start fresh. And one of the best things about a new year is it's a clean slate. This is your chance to really, really do things for yourself in a better way. I want to talk to you guys about some suggestions. I don't like the word resolution because it comes with a negative connotation. So we're not going to use the word resolution. We're going to say suggestions. So these are my suggestions for you. I know you guys are staring at a blank screen, but my mind is thinking about what I want to draw. So the first suggestion is one that is probably, like, if you're going to only listen to one of these at all, you know what I mean? If you're only going to listen to one, and you could stop watching after this video if you want to, as this is the most important one, and that's to love yourself. More important than anything else is to find appreciation and love for yourself. And that is the one thing that we all seem to suck at the most. I'm just going to draw a little, like, I don't know why, but I feel like this shirt needs to have some detail on it. Maybe that's the fashion designer in me, but there you go. So it's really important every day to find ways to love and appreciate yourself. We are our own worst critics all the time. It's easy for us to get down on ourselves, to pick ourselves apart. Oh, I wish I was this, I wish I was that. And, you know, we all do it. No matter how gorgeous you are, no matter how, you know, amazing you are, how intelligent you are, we all do it. We all have those moments where we pick ourselves apart and where we go, you know, we turn against ourselves and, oh, I wish I could be like this person, I wish I could be like that person. But, you know, you are who you are, and you're the way you are for a reason. Your whole life has made you the person that you are. And it's important this year to really start accepting yourself for who you are. It's really important for you to fall in love with yourself and accept yourself, your flaws, your issues. You are who you are, you know what I mean? And you're gonna have a much happier, better life if you can find things to love about yourself. And you are gonna be more confident, and you're gonna be able to get through things if you just find things about yourself to really love and cherish and appreciate. And it can be difficult, and I just drew these eyes so crooked, but who cares? This girl's gonna have crooked eyes, and she's gonna love herself because her eyes are crooked, and that's just who she is. She's happy with herself. So we all can tend to pick apart our flaws. And I did a video recently about this, like, I am lovable and capable. But this is something that you guys are still kind of, you know, we all deal with on a regular basis. And it's really important to find ways to really have that love and appreciation for yourself. Because if you want to have a good career, if you want to have a happy relationship, if you want to find, you know, somebody to date and love, it all starts with feeling good about yourself. You know, you have to think of yourself in a way kind of like an energy ball, okay? So we are all made of flesh and bone and, you know, all that good stuff. There's my little skeleton guy here. We're all made of flesh and bone, but no matter how much we're made of organic matter, the thing about all of us that gets us through every day, gets us where we're going, and is the biggest way that people react to us is the energy we give off. You have to look at yourself almost like this light bulb. And we all have this energy that is around us all the time. And so the way you feel about yourself is the way your energy relates. So if you're confident and happy and you're feeling good about yourself, your energy is going to beam. That bulb is going to burn bright, and it's going to be the most beautiful, warm, radiant light that you could ever imagine. And people will respond to you. And they're not going to notice if you have bags under your eyes. And they're not going to notice if you have, you know, wrinkled laugh lines. They're not going to notice if you have small boobs. They're not going to notice if your hair's a mess, which mine usually is. They're not going to notice those things because they're just going to sense this beautiful, warm energy around you. They're not going to notice if you have freckles, which, by the way, freckles can be really cute. So, but some people don't like their freckles, so I'm putting it in there. They're not going to notice if you're a little bit overweight. They're not going to notice any of that stuff because they're going to see this warm, radiant light, and that's what they're going to respond to. That's the energy. But that warm, radiant light doesn't just appear by itself. It comes from within, and you have to create it. And the way to create it is to really fall in love with yourself, who you are, and you know, and be honest about it. If you think about little kids, okay, a little kid, say like 6 months old or 9 months old or whatever, I'm gonna give this kid some funny hair because that's just the mood I'm in, but little kids look at themselves in the mirror and they love their reflection. You know, they just love their reflection. They get so excited to see their little reflections in the mirror. And they don't know exactly maybe what they're looking at, but they know they love it. They know it makes them happy. And they have this joy. And that's one of the reasons people like little kids so much, because they're just joyous and happy. And they just have that beautiful energy. You want to be around them a lot of the time because there's just so much fun. So a little kid will look at themselves in the mirror and they'll just laugh and smile. They love what they see because they haven't been knocked down. They haven't been criticized. They haven't been told they have weird teeth or weird ears or that they're not attractive or that their skin's too pale or whatever. And so, or their skin's too dark. They haven't had any of those negative things. And so they just see this beautiful thing in front of them and they just love it. They don't know to find the flaws. So it's really important for you guys to see yourself in the same way. Once you get this energy burning bright and radiant, you'll be shocked and amazed at the way that people react to you. And it's really important to find ways to appreciate yourself. And one of the best things that I can tell you guys to do is to journal yourself, and journal every day, and just find ways to write down good things about yourself. Like every day you should be writing down good things that happened to you, good things you did. You don't have to write down the bad things. If you want to, you can, of course. I don't want to stifle you guys, but if you're feeling depressed or having a particularly hard time, write down the good things that happened to you throughout the day. Even if the only good thing that happened to you was that you had the most delicious cup of coffee ever, and it was like the best coffee that you've ever had in your life. Even if that was like the only thing that happened to you, then write that down. You know what I mean? Or if you figured out how to fix your computer, or if you figured out how to, I don't know, I was trying to draw a polar bear, but it turned into a mouse. So that is life. But even if that is the only thing that happened to you, write it down. Write down the good qualities you have. And another thing that I would suggest is to write down on like a piece of paper, on your bathroom mirror, on a whiteboard, near your computer, near places that you frequent. The refrigerator is a good one. Write down good qualities about yourself, like that you might have nice handwriting, which obviously I don't right now, but that you have nice handwriting, or that you're a good cook, or that you have pretty eyes, or that you're healthy. Anything. Write these things down so that you can see them and be reminded by them. So start to really fall in love with yourself. The other thing is, try not to compare yourself to other people. When you are on social media, and I'm on social media a lot, you see people on social media and you feel like they look perfect. Like, I always see these girls that are like 20 years old and they have like perfect eyebrows and they have big beautiful eyes and then they have really big beautiful lips, which I'm a little jealous of because my lips are tiny. And then they have like these great cheekbones and, you know, this great beautiful flowing curly thick hair. You know, they have like all this stuff. And it's easy to compare yourself to these people and be like, oh my goodness, she kind of looks like Janice from the Muppets. It's easy to compare yourself to these people and be like, oh my God, I could never look like that. I'm not like that. And that's the ideal. And I don't fit the ideal. But you're never going to be happy comparing yourself. And you got to know also, this girl that seems so perfect, she's comparing herself to somebody else. She's looking in the mirror and saying, I wish I didn't have this. I wish I didn't have that freckle. I wish that my lips maybe weren't so big. I feel like they're too big. Or I wish that my face didn't have these cheekbones. Whatever the case may be, everybody has insecurities. No matter how beautiful somebody is, no matter how amazing they are, they have insecurities. So the first resolution, or the second resolution, is to not try not to compare yourself or your life to anybody else. You have to create the life that you want, and you can't focus or compare it to what somebody else has. You have to create your own level of happiness, because your ideal happiness may not be their ideal happiness, and you're going to try to kill yourself to create their ideal happiness, and it's not going to bring you happiness. So love yourself and don't compare yourself to other people. The third thing is to stop the negative expressions and talking. This is a huge one. We do it. I do it all the time. And my thing is to stop this. We talk, and we don't even think about what we're saying. And we say things all the time like, I can't afford that. That is the worst thing you could say to yourself when it comes to trying to attract prosperity. I can't afford that. I don't have money for that. Now, you may want to buy a new Maserati, and you may not have the money for that, but you don't want to ever say, I can't afford that. I don't have money for that. What you want to say is, I will buy that when I get the money, or I will buy that in the future, or someday I will have that car, or I will afford that car someday. You want to always be positive. So you don't want to say this. Even when you're with your kids and they're like, Mom, can I have some candy? You don't ever want to say to your kids, no, we can't afford that. No, we don't have money for that. Because you're creating a poverty consciousness for your little kids. And you don't want to have them growing up with it, because you got it from your parents. You know what I mean? So you don't want to do that to your little kids. You can say, no, I'm not buying you candy because you had candy yesterday. Or no, I'm not buying you any candy because you don't need candy right now. Or maybe we'll get that candy another time. But you don't have to tell them it's because you can't afford it or you don't have the money for it. You don't want to create that negativity. Another thing that we all do, including me, I've done this and I'm trying to stop the habit, is whenever you make a mistake, you say things like, oh, I'm dumb. I'm stupid. I'm a dope. I'm an idiot. I spelled idiot wrong. I really look like an idiot now. So you don't want to say these things. You know, if you make a mistake, say, hey, I made a mistake. I shouldn't have done that. Or, oh, wow, I thought it was this way and I did that way. Oh, I left the soup on too long and I shouldn't have. Or, oh, I forgot to let my dog out. Or, oh, I forgot to pay that bill. You know, but don't say things like, I'm dumb, I'm stupid. The subconscious mind is like a little sponge, okay? Your subconscious mind is deep inside of you, and it is like an absorbent sponge, and all those negative words that you think are so like minute and nothing, they seep in there and they affect you. And when you're saying to yourself that you don't think you can pass a test, or you don't think that you can do a certain type of career, or you can't go back to school, it's because every day you say things like, I'm stupid, I can't. Another thing that you should stop saying is, I can't. We all say that all the time. I can't do this. I can't do that. I can't figure that out. I'm not good at this. I'm not good at that. You have to stop saying that. If you don't want to do something, say you don't want to do it. Like, I do not want to go jogging right now. Don't say, I can't go jogging right now. Say, I don't want to. I don't want to is a better energy, because you're taking responsibility and control, and you're being honest with yourself. So I don't want to go jogging. I don't want to learn how to play that video game. I don't want to is much more powerful than I can't. Try to avoid saying I can't. Another thing is, you don't want to say things like, I'm fat, or I'm ugly, or I'm old. A lot of people say I'm old all the time. I hear people say I'm old, even when they're young. I heard 16-year-olds say I'm old, which is ridiculous. You don't want to say I'm old. That is the worst thing to say. I'm almost mad at myself right now because I said it like 5 times. I strive myself to never say this about myself. I always say forever young, 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 young. I don't want to ever say like I'm never getting old, because you're still putting the old in there. And so you always want to say things like, oh, I'm so glad I'm young. I feel so good. I feel so young. I look so young, 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 young. You always want to emphasize like that part of it. And it's easy to feel like you're this, but you don't want to exacerbate it. So try to find ways to feel the better thing, which is young. You want to feel young, and you want to keep emphasizing young, and it will show in your energy, in your physical health. You have to kind of really be conscious of the things that you say. You also want to avoid saying that you're ill a lot. Like, I'm ill. I always get ill. I get ill all the time. Now, some people do have chronic illnesses. I'm not trying to take away from you guys who have chronic illnesses. But like people who are the regular, average, everyday people, they say all the time, like, oh, I don't feel well. I'm tired. I don't feel good. And, you know, maybe you're just tired, or maybe you're just, you know, have a headache or something. But you exacerbate it to like this big thing instead of just taking control of it. And there's a lot of fear of like, oh, I don't want to get sick. I'm so afraid of getting sick. Well, you're emphasizing getting sick, so you're more than likely going to get sick. I barely ever get sick, and it's because I always say I'm so healthy. I never, you know, I always have good health. I'm you know, really healthy. I don't have any health issues. You know, I'm healthy, healthy, healthy. So you want to focus on that. So love yourself. Don't compare yourself to anybody else. Stop with the negative talk, the negative self-talk. This one and this one are probably going to be the hardest ones for you guys to consider. But if you can master these, you will have such a better 2018. And I really want you to have a good 2018. I want to have a good 2018. Let's have a good 2018 together. Let's enjoy this year. Let's kick this year's ass and have like the best 2018 ever. You know what I mean? But we have to do it in a good way. We have to start this year off on a clean slate and in a good space, and really, really, really work on these things. And I shouldn't even say the word work, because it's not about work. It's about living each day. I'm going to do a little heart here. Living each day to be happy and just joyful and appreciative of things. If I'm going to add one other thing to this list of suggestions, and they're just suggestions, they're not resolutions, they're not, you know, you don't have to be forced to do these things, it's suggestions from your mama, because I love you, is try not to engage in tearing people down or gossip. I am going to be honest with you and say that sometimes it's fun to sit there with your friends and be like, oh my God, can you believe what she is wearing? Oh my God, can you believe that she did that? Can you believe that she is with that guy? Can you believe that she did this or did that? Listen, we're human. We all do these things. And it's very, very normal to get into the gossip. And it's fun to gossip. And sometimes it could be fun to write negative comments to people online, because you're hurting and you're feeling bad that day and you feel like that's going to make you feel better. But we have to try not to tear each other down. We have to try to find ways to build each other up. And one of the things that I do all the time, and sometimes people get embarrassed when they're with me, is I will stop people in the streets and I will be like, girl, I love your coat. You have the nicest nails. I love your hair. Your hair is beautiful. You have gorgeous shoes. I love your shoes. I find things to compliment people about. So instead of tearing people down, try to build them up. Try to build them up. Compliment people. Sincere compliments. It's not like in Mean Girls when she's like, oh, that's such a cute shirt, skirt. And then she's like, oh, that's the ugliest skirt I've ever seen. Compliment people sincerely. Even if they're strangers. It will make somebody's day. They may act weird at first because they're like, why are you coming up to me, stranger, and talking to me about my shoes? But 99% of the time, actually 100% of the time, they've responded very positively about it, and they have it has put a smile on their face. So, compliment people. If you're watching a video, leave a nice compliment. If you're walking down the street and you see somebody and they have a nice smile, tell them they have a nice smile. It will make them feel better, but it'll also make you feel better. You're spreading that positivity, and that's helping your own energy radiate. And you want your energy to radiate. You want people to respond well to you. Because the truth is, as a human race, we may think that we see like the face or you know what I mean, the respond to the physical form, but we don't. We're all just responding to energy. So we're all these like little energy blobs, and we respond to energy. And some people have really nice, pretty energy, and we run to them and we're like, oh, we love them so much. They have great energy. And some people have more negative energy, and we don't like them as much because we respond to that negative energy. And so that's what it is. We're all these energy beings, and you want to have your energy really good. And the best way to have your energy good is to do the suggestions that I said, which is love yourself, no negative self-talk, and don't tear anybody else down, don't compare yourself to anybody else. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I love making these types of videos for you guys. They make me really, really happy. I feel like it's a lot of fun to sit and draw and talk with you guys. And I hope that you guys enjoy them as well. If you guys have any suggestions for any of these draw talk style videos, you can always comment below and I will do them for you. And in the meantime, let me write this in calligraphy because I want to be fancy. In the meantime, happy. I'm not the best calligraphy person, but I think I did a pretty good job. I almost wrote happy birthday. Happy new year. And I love you. If you like this video, you can do me a favor and give it a good old thumbs up because that helps out the channel and it's really, really helpful to me. So give that good old thumbs up for me. You can comment below and you could let me know what you thought. And I will see you guys in my next video. I hope you have a marvelous day and an even more marvelous year.